The question, as a writer, how would you describe yourself as a character in a novel? She has short black hair with speckles of gray and brown. Her eyes reminded me of the marble floor in my home, black and shiny, especially when she laughed, they shone so brightly. I liked that she wasn't short nor tall. She could be tall among certain short people and then, she could be short among certain tall people. What I loved most though was her skin. It made me think of very dark brown chocolate, the kind I suspected would be very sweet like she was. I looked over at her, the 1000th time in 5 minutes. She was laughing now. Her hands went up to her mouth as she tried to contain herself. I wish she were like this every day. I wish she could be like this with me one day, but selfishly I was happy she wasn't like this with everyone. I observed she was only open and comfortable with people she wanted to. She chose whom she was going to be herself with. She'd choose me one day. Every other day, if she wasn't with any one of her friends, they were fine. I didn't count. I'd see her all by herself, listening to music, her ears plugged in with an earpiece, or she could be reading a book. Most times, I didn't see her. I only saw her after lectures and if I was lucky, in the refectory when I go to eat. After eating, I sit and watch her till she's done. I sighed. I could just walk up to her and start a conversation. I've watched guys do it. It made me furious. She plugs out her earpiece and attempt to smile. Sometimes she laughed while they talked. Most times, she'd look irritated and still smile. She didn't want their company and I didn't know how they couldn't see that. Today, I was going to make her choose me. I watched them, she and her friends, they were just two today. They got on their feet, pushing their chairs back with their legs and began marching to the door, passing my table. She sauntered behind them, trying to untangle her earpiece. I stood up from where I was sat with so much force, the chair almost toppled over. I got hold of it quickly and pushed it under the table. She was still struggling with her tangled earpiece when I walked up to her. "Hi," I said, trying to hide the nervousness in my voice. "Hi." The quiet, dark-skinned girl looked up at me.